Kayvon Chocat at UCSF. I'm in the Department of Cellular and Molecular Pharmacology. I'm also a professor of chemistry at UC Berkeley, and I'm an investigator of the Howard Hughes Medical Institute. I think I just got fascinated with chemistry in college and, you know, had a great set of professors that really captivated my imagination about chemistry. And I was also starting to be a biology major, but the chemistry just kept sort of being more and more interesting. So then that's what led me to combine the two in chemical biology.
That interest in chemical biology set Dr. Chocat on a path to solve one of cancer biology's most difficult puzzles, how to target the cancer-causing protein KRAS. Although researchers discovered KRAS in 1982, because of its complex structure, developing a targeted therapy posed significant challenges. At the AACR annual meeting 2022, Dr. Chocat received the AACR Award for Outstanding Achievement in Chemistry and Cancer Research for his contributions to the development of a KRAS-targeted therapeutic.
We became interested in the signaling enzymes, the molecules that sort of send signals from the membrane to the nucleus, and those are mutated across all cancers. So we kind of follow the protein and then wherever that takes us for the cancer. I think the things I'm most proud of in the lab that are the ability that we developed back in the late 90s to pinpoint the role of any protein kinase. This is the largest gene family, like 500 kinases, but a whole group of patients didn't have kinase mutations. They had mutations in a GTPase called KRAS, and that protein was just, we didn't even have any starting point for that. And so my lab took some tricks that we learned from the kinase work and started inch by inch sort of applying it to KRAS, and that led to the discovery in 2013 of this drug pocket on KRAS.
Dr. Chocat and his team designed and tested a drug called sotorasib, which binds in the pocket they discovered. In 2021, the FDA approved sotorasib for the treatment of lung tumors harboring a common KRAS mutation.
I was looking forward to the next 5 or 10 years seeing drugs that would target the other KRAS alleles, like the one that's dominant in pancreatic cancer and other mutations that our drug and the ones that followed don't target. And I thought that would be the 10-year plan, but it's here already. It's amazing. You know, science is very competitive. Companies compete for market share. Academic scientists compete for, you know, papers and grants. But when you come here, you get the feeling that everybody is here for the patient and they're looking for the answer, asking each other hard questions. The other reason the public, I think, needs to, you know, realize the value of that is that we need those fundamental discoveries to understand basic, you know, cell biology, basic tissue biology, basic developmental biology, because tumors use all of that. The goal of the research was to make an impact for cancer patients. So to have the chemistry recognized, you know, by the AACR is really, really special, because the award has been given to a number of really, really amazing, outstanding, you know, achievers, and to be included in that is wonderful. And it means a lot to the lab. It means a lot to, you know, the people who fund me. So I really appreciate that. You know, to discover a drug, there are so many stages. So it really takes the continuum from the university to the small companies to the big companies. And even at that point, it really needs the patient advocates. So there's so many people that contribute to the responses of the patients. And so that's partly what you see here at AACR. You see all those people get together, and that's, I think, really, really powerful, impactful too. Thank you.